Yes, and apparently Woolies is sticking some stock on ships to get it across the Nullarbor. It is... The things that are missing are odd, like there's no cold brand products at all. And the two coal stores are quite different, like the one in Arana has one tub of So Good chocolate ice cream. The one in town has four tubs of vanilla and about half a dozen tubs of chocolate. The one in Arana has zero gluten-free, dairy-free biscuits. The one in town has one packet of chips. But the other things are going in absentia. There doesn't seem to be any particular pattern to it at all. Little things like there's heaps of standard milk of various kinds. But at the moment, Arana has no cold brand soy milk at all. Sweet Valley stopped retail selling. Yeah, standing on a sandhill. Beautiful view of town. Keep getting away from people for a little while. Elder and his missus drove to Perth yesterday and expect to return on Monday. Yeah, it's only $1.70 odd a litre down here. And listening to people in the US whinge about 49 cents a gallon. He's running the men's camp starting two Fridays from now. What's his name? Who's out in Torbay anyway? Rutherford Road. Have had the jab, according to him. Yes. And he has also contracted the disease in question, he reckons, and doesn't wish to see it on anyone else. The fact that he hasn't put two and two together is telling by itself. May have said that, but it's only half correct. Yes, the mRNA, which when it's injected, turns you into what's called a shifra, spelled CH, which is two organisms living in one body. One consisting of parts of you amalgamated with the mRNA, and one consisting of parts of you not amalgamated with the mRNA. It doesn't actually alter your DNA unless you happen to have an HIV infection or something like that around, which will alter your DNA. But the patent owner of the mRNA owns the shimmer part of you, and they're inseparable. An annual license, yes. But meanwhile, Hillary is in deep manure in the US. This Russian conspiracy thing with Trump, completely set up by her group, and a high-level lawyer has begun to untangle it. All this public denial she made on the airwaves, all a matter of public record, all completely false, and she knew it. But it was done in such a way that it's obvious she knew it. It's not just, you know, she must have, she obviously did. Now, Mr. Trump is not a straight story, but I'd much rather him than kill him in power. And 12 senators are calling for Joe Biden to undergo cognitive testing. Basically to prove that he's sane, which ain't gonna fly. Yes. When you're on a live broadcast, and you mention that you cannot read the teleprompter, you're definitely not with it. They can't even stage something with him anymore, it's that far gone. But meanwhile, the rest of the world is going crazy each in its own way. China has had the bomb. Yeah, they ran out of food, they ran out of money, the major flooding in many areas. They unified Africa. When they debt trapped Kenya and seized their borders collateral, Kenya mucked around with legislation about 18 months and then said, no, you can't, took it back. Every single African nation agreed with them. Probably for the first time in history. But all of the ASEAN nations, everyone including Thailand, have united against China. Thailand is no longer digging a canal, China wanted. So China still have to send boats past. And all the pirates. Lithuania sparked a firestorm. They opened a Taiwanese embassy. Thailand, this is Taiwan. Think about that. China's backlash against that was so obviously excessive that quite a number of other nations paid official attention to it. A number of other people have figured out that with China in power, they're in the US and whatever they can do with that. Meanwhile, Mr. Altheimer is putting Russia and China together. Which, of course, will fly like a dirty duck. Mr. Putin is not dumb enough. And some of his moves, there's no warning. None. That's the nearest announcement and it's all over. Pack up your cards, go home if you don't like it. But India has been doing a huge number of other things, so if there is another world power, I'm sure it will be India. And one conflict built right into it is that India itself is not interested in power over other nations. And yet it's likely to become a world power almost accidentally. Yep. Well, the cooperation in the United States of America will be brought down. In legal docs, it's always written in all caps. Because under maritime law equals admiralty law equals Roman law, that's a corporation, not a person, not a nation. Yeah, and China will come a cropper. Exactly how, we're not sure. Who else they'll take out, we're not sure. But China and India have one thing in common. One. Every district, province, county, call it what you will, is different to every other. And in both nations, each province or whatever prefers the local rules to the national rules. To give you some idea of one of the differences, one province in China is run by a matriarch. Within that province, there is no such thing as marriage. Women have children with whomever they want. Quite a lot of Chinese nationals living near the border have fled to other nations to avoid starving. And that's quite a number, that's not one of them. Yeah. And the closed down 1/4 of their coal mines. In November, Indonesia banned coal exports to China. And then nickel exports. So China's stealing for stuff, much of the thing. And also the unusually severe winter. They want coal for heat. And factories and stuff, they don't get them. Delhi in India has had snow for the first time since 1957. They have scores of people freezing to death every night. This is in the lowlands, this is not in the mountains area. And the rest of the world in similar straits. And they've been people in Australia in Malaysia, oddly enough, in the first 3 days last year. The lowest is at the end of last month, it snowed in Texas and Florida. It doesn't snow in Florida. Florida's a small place. If I want down the inside of the thing a little bit,
from India.
Do
you go for a real drink though?
No.
Oh. Yeah, okay. Because I do, that's why.
Yeah, he quit at 77 and he turned 86 in November.
Oh, nice.
He lives 880 kilometers that way.
Oh.
India's an interesting place, hasn't it? For a very long time.
Yeah, have you been there?
No.
No.
My first ever Indian girl, expected a girlfriend officially, 4 decades ago, was Anglo Indian. Unusual, she had 2 Anglo Indian parents who were not Indian.
Oh, nice.
But Mr. Modi is doing interesting things at the moment.
Mr. Modi is doing things interesting.
Yes. Anyway, I'll finish my phone call and you can go.
Video le raha hai. Kahan se? Pata nahi yaha se bol raha tha.
But the weather is going cranky very quickly. Right here. The past few years that were
यहाँ से अगर आप उतर जाए तो गाड़ी तक पहुँच जाओगे तो रोड आ रही है ना यहाँ खड़े हो कॉम्प्लेन कंपनी है का लुक बहुत अच्छा है ब्रांडिंग में समझ तो ही पा रहा है
It's a wavy bank band.
Done.
Done.
So you get a
हाथों तो अच्छी आ रही है, स्वेटर में डालू क्या?
स्वेटर के सच में
करते महिमा हम ना इन लोग को बोलते नीचे आओ हम वहां मिलते
पकड़े
यार ड्रोन में भी मेरे स्वेटर आया।
अबे तुमने जो फोकस लगाया ना उसमें तुम आ ही नहीं रहे
तो आपको पीछे आना पड़ेगा ना
तो
मेरे चेहरे पे टैप करना
yep.
थोड़ा आड़ा हो जाओ
This is called the Jimmy's. east of Delhi first and we have the temperature. I've got all the pages scanned except for one missing piece of paper. There is a bloke living in Melbourne who has an elderly wife. When he goes to church on Sunday, he will get a copy of the same book, scan each side of the piece of paper and email it to me. The OCR is working reasonably well, mostly using the windmill layout rather than spell check and sort of stuff. But I have scanned all the remaining pages and OCR'd them. And we'll see how the rest goes. But I think, I don't know about prophecy or whatever, but just having a look at the strategy, right now Albany's about the best and safest place in the world to live. Okay. Yes. Yep. Yep. Mother-in-law Teresa picked her up this morning and took her to have a look at some of the place in Spencer Park. So I don't really close to doing things like that. No change in attitude. Yes, and Teresa has basically told her many times, I'm sorry, you can't live with us. And Mum is not accepting that. She agrees, and then 10 minutes later she asks. Her life is so drenched with